My good friend, Matthew Hussle, aka Snorlax Sleepy, link in the description, and at the end of the video probably, is getting married in Scotland tomorrow. So, it's been a while since I've done a vlog on the Chrisisnotthattall channel. I've been mainly focusing on the short Chris one. I thought I'd do a little vlog for you, because I don't know if anybody else will, so... here's a free wedding video, Hussle, I guess. See you there. So I'm just waiting for John and Emily to arrive from Wales, because for some reason they've decided they're going to drive all the way down from Wales to pick me up and then take me up to Scotland. So thank you, John and Emily. You'll possibly see them in the next bit if they're cool with being on the camera. I know they are. Expect a John moment. Say hello, John.
So here we are, guys. We're going underground to the Wallasey Tunnel. Because we're freaking classy, none of that Queensway scum. Kingsway right here, like a bunch of misogynists. It's wonderful, it's just completely straight on. No turns, no like creepy unused branch, you know, that like just sits there looming at you, kind of looking like some kind of sea monster. It's amazing. And Stevens, do you want to tell us where we're going today?
So I told you there'd be a John moment, didn't I? We're off to Scotland to see a Hussle get married.
Hussle's wielding.
Hussle's wielding.
Not a wedding, wielding.
It's Hussle's welding.
He's getting welded to Hannah forever. And welcome back to the vlog. Now, we are currently driving through Cumbria, the English lakes. As you can see, there are mountains and lakes. This is also where Peter Rabbit lives. So if Stevens at any point a rabbit should start talking to you, I would advise you listen and accept anything he offers you.
On a better note, my battery is about to die, so we'll see you in Scotland. So we've all come to Spoons. Scoey's here.
And he's tired, but he's getting through it.
He's gonna forget his speech tomorrow, and I'm gonna drop the mic on him.
But I'm drinking lots of these, so I can forget that I'm doing a speech in front of about 80, 90 people tomorrow. I don't do this often, you never do this often. So as you can imagine, yeah, plenty of these, at least two, I think.
Yeah. What is the magic word?
I've got the last words apparently. So yeah, I'm getting married tomorrow. It's weird. It's like, I'm getting married. Like, who'd have thought that was going to happen? If you go back in time, I've had a long history of my life. I was all about the bitches, money and hoes. And that was my thing. I wasn't very successful with them. But it was my thing nonetheless. And now I'm getting married in Scotland and I have a pint of beer. But I'm excited. And I'm excited to spend the rest of my life with Hannah. To be soppy, it's the best thing ever happened to me. You are. So here's to many happy years. And also to alcohol, the cause of and solution to all of life's problems. Peace out. It's a long delay, Stevens. When do we stop the video?
Hi, this is my final message. I can't believe I'm getting married tomorrow. That's crazy. You're cool, Matt. And I just can't believe it, and I love you very much.
Welcome to Jake Saunders camp. I've always wanted to do this because everyone hijacks my high quality 1080 HD DSLR film vlogs. Check them out at JTS Media. Hussle, if you're watching this, it means I'm dead. This year, the two people that I would expect to get married last both got married.
Yeah.
John and Hussle getting married first is one of those surreal sentences I think I'll ever say.
Would be us now.
hustle.
Normally I'm very anxious about it.
I've only known you for about 5 years now, but it's been the most ridiculous 5 years. It's been the most ridiculous 5 years. It's been an honour to tolerate your existence. Hannah is a lovely person. Do not fuck this up. Because we'll all beat your ass with sticks. Other than that, have an amazing day. You'll be watching this in about 6 months when Stephen's actually gets around to editing it. But love you loads. Enjoy being married. Wait a little bit before popping out the kids so you don't become another statistic to society. But love you loads. Oh, okay, you just wanted to do that.
It was quite an unflattering angle.
They're all unflattering.
Fine, they're all like that. Hustle.
And I said,
oh, met you a while back. I still remember our first New Year's party at Pete's girlfriend's house. You got so drunk that you vomited in your own beard and said,
at the end of the day, women are a f***ing mess.
We've gone on through the years, we had our band, we had the Ballads of Corby Road, many, many great hits, that wondrous guitar solo for myself, with you playing bass and keeping up in time. Yeah, thanks for being awesome friends and fucking off to Scotland without telling me. And now you're getting married. Holy crap. So, two of the imbeciles of our group in 1 year getting married. I'm still single as hell and need to really catch up. So, who are we thinking? Jake or Tom next? Anyway, have an amazing time. I expect Hannah to have a bump when she comes back from Turkey. Yeah. You're getting married. Holy crap. What?
Right. Hello, everybody. Right. So, it's the night before Hustle's wedding. I feel a bit... I don't really know how to like explain it really, because tomorrow afternoon I've got to do a best man speech. I've got it all prepared, but I can't really express how I feel right now really, because my best friend's getting married, and as much as I'm delighted for him and it's so lovely, I'm still thinking, is this really happening? Like, it's a bit surreal, but it's such a amazing thing, and you'll see tomorrow, you know, you'll see what it's like being friends with him for the past 17 years, the mental and physical effect it's had on me, but yes, that'll all be revealed tomorrow, but no, I'm just happy me at the moment for him, and you know, I can't express how proud I am of him, because he's come to Scotland like for a new life really, and I think I'm just a bit humbled that like he's got a lovely new family and he's got a job that, well, I don't know if he loves the job, but you know, he's got like a job that he's doing well in, and he's got a house, and you know, his wife, well, his wife to be is lovely, his family are lovely, and yeah, I'm just, I suppose I do miss him, of course, but at the same time, I sort of feel that he's done so well since, and I can't really say any more than that. I think I speak for myself, like for friends and for family as well. So, yeah, there's nothing much. I mean, you'll see all tomorrow, I'm sure, because I'm sure this young man who's recording will have my speech all prepared. But yeah, so night before, I'm gonna drink to forget that I'm doing a speech tomorrow, and see how it goes. So, right, I'm gonna leave you with this. So, peace out.
Right, down that now. So, it's official. Hustle's tipsy before the wedding.
I'm not drunk, but I'm definitely merry.
Yeah, it's gonna be a good wedding.
We're gonna have to say goodbye, by the way.
Gonna get married.
Going to the chapel, God, gonna get married.
My poor savings account.
That's not the big deal here. The biggest deal here is the fact that I will no longer, ever, ever be able to pull anybody on those stairs anymore.
Oh God!
No,
Save it for the wedding. It's the big day. Matt and Hannah are getting married. I'm all ready. I've got my stag pin from John's wedding as well. Gonna keep that theme going for every wedding I ever go to with the gang. Yeah, time to head down to the wedding. Exciting. So we're making the walk up to the old hall for Garland Shields, where Matt and Hannah are gonna get married. Just walking past the volunteer hall where I'll be DJing tonight. Exciting. I can't wait to see what they look like. Hustle apparently is humongously hungover, as he should be. This is gonna be fun. So naturally, Jake's found a gym at the halls.
Oh no! That's annoying. Not walking all the way to the
other side. Hello, you handsome bar stools. Welcome to the alternative wedding vlog.
I know, weird, isn't it? I'm getting married.
No, you're not.
Still trying to hang on to.
Callum is severely hungover. Scoey is Scoey, and Jake is playing Pokemon.
No, I'm not.
Oh wow! Yeah, wait, you're not being a nerd anymore?
No. So you can do it, fellow nerds. You can do it. You can play Pokemon Go and engage in sexual intercourse on a regular basis. You can do it. You just need to be very good looking and have a large penis.
That is the best interview we'll ever have on Hustle's wedding video.
That is the extra stuff after
it. Or you can be like me, play Pokemon Go and have no sexual intercourse ever. So it's either one or the other. Yeah. So he's on one end of the spectrum, I'm on the other end of the spectrum.
He's
so.
Just on the spectrum.
Like, I walked right into that one then, didn't I? Yeah. this speech. Which is
microphones.
You might have one. Can't talk to the robot.
No, I was wondering. Just
hi.
Lovely, so thank you all for making the effort to turn up and the effort to come down here. It's beautiful. We'll do a proper speech later on. This is just ad lib, which Hannah told me to do it. So I hope you're having a nice time. There's still food left, help yourselves, and have a few drinks and enjoy yourselves. That's it.
So this is my job for the night. Playing the Spotify playlist. Go and follow It's a Mannah Wedding on Spotify for some class tunes. Here's the view for the night.
Always gotta make sure.
I hope everyone mingles around and makes some friends. Some of you may have already met last year at the party at the Laddip. That was very engaging. We also appreciate that some people aren't here tonight. Some people couldn't make it and send their best wishes. And some people are no longer with us. My granddad would have really enjoyed tonight. And although there's an empty space without him here, there is a much fuller bar. I've got a few thank yous to make. Firstly, I'd like to thank the ushers. Thank you guys for everything, and Hannah wants to apologise for stealing that away from you, and they wish they could see you much more often than they can. I'd also like to thank the best men, Callum and Sco. Job. They're so great together that they promised they're going to be doing the gay gardens later for all of us. For the portion of the audience who aren't Scottish, I'll let you imagine what that entails. And doesn't Hannah look beautiful? And I'm not just saying that because she looks like me. Thank you for making me your maid of honour. And thank you for being my favourite sister. Me and Ryan grew up only 14 months apart, and we did everything together.
So I showed my stand-up routine to my good lady wife in Moral Compass. That's now a speech again. So, good evening. First of all, though, I'm going to start with a complaint. I'd just like to say how disappointed I was to be asked to give Hannah away. Because I'd actually planned on selling her. But there you go. And as I look around, and says, Hannah, not one of you people in this room could afford her. Just saying. I understand that as father of the bride, my role is actually to thank everybody, all of you, and I'll get round to that eventually. I've known Hannah for all of my life. No, sorry, I've known Hannah for all of her life. And I want to spend a wee bit of time talking about her, given this is her big day and everything. I've just seen her face now. From a very young age, as was alluded to by her mum's lovely speech at the wedding ceremony today, Hannah was obsessed by princesses. That's the, not the real ones, I'll leave that for the Daily Mail readers and stuff, but more of the Disney variety other companies are available. And there she is, look at her, everybody, on her wedding day, all dressed up. Having all the attention, looking beautiful, and this is her Princess Day.
That's all we need to take you get tonight, so enjoy that. It's it's fair to say there's going to be a few toasts over the next couple of minutes that I'm doing this. So make sure we've all got full glasses. Apart from Andrew at the back there. So try to spend 5 minutes waiting to go. She already broke.
No.
So there's no more thank yous before I get emotional here. So thanks to everyone today for making it, especially those who have travelled a long way to make it here today. It means so much to us. And secondly, thanks to my mum and dad. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here today. Literally, I wouldn't be here today. And thank you to my new family, my new in-laws. You've all been amazing since I moved to Scotland. You've made me feel so welcome, and I couldn't be more honoured to be part of an amazing family, so thank you very much. Also, thank you for bringing up Hannah to be the special person she is.
Aww.
I get to spend the rest of my life with her, and I'd like to take this time as well to thank the bridesmaids. Luckily, none of them are single, apart from my sister, so Schofield, unfortunately, she's not with us tonight. And finally, thank you to my ushers. You guys dragged me through life kicking and screaming, sometimes quite literally. I wouldn't be standing here in front of you all without you, and honestly, thank you. No words can ever explain my gratitude to all of you. And lastly, thank you to people who can't be here tonight. I know people have covered this already, but there's people who are longer with us, especially my granddad. For those of you who don't know my granddad, he was one of the most amazing people ever lived. And honestly, I am upset he's not here today, and we all are. But if there is a God above, he's sitting up there looking at us over here. So we raise our glasses to Roy, please.
To Roy!
But above all else, today is a day to celebrate love. Not just love myself and Hannah, but all romantic, platonic, and everything else in between. Because anything this world really needs more of, it's love. Right, it's all out of the way, so let's get to the good bit then. So, I met the most amazing person in the world. She made every day complete. Go to the next page. I'm not actually reading this story. And I honestly couldn't imagine my life without her. Unfortunately, she didn't leave me when I met Hannah. You did tell me to cut out, but I started against it. I do joke though, from the day I met Hannah, I knew there was something different about her. There was just a small issue though, happened to live 300 miles away from her. The thing is, this day almost never happened. See, one day Hannah went off to Ireland. She sent me a text, I never got it. She protested it didn't happen, I genuinely never got it. I honestly never got it, so I assumed she just met someone else or got bored and moved on, and that's it. Well, so, well, she lives in Scotland, like, probably not going to work out. I'll just get on with life. About 3 months later, I decided to drop her a quick text message. There may have been a small issue between that time, probably come right here today. And I honestly never looked back. The next thing I knew, about 3 weeks later, I was on the train, I was coming to Edinburgh to meet her. And that today I wouldn't change for the world. It was one of the most exciting and incredible days of my life. Also, probably one of the happiest days of my mum's life. She mentioned when we finally got me out of that spare bedroom. A wise man once said something. Being somebody else is the waste of the person you are. Well, since I met Hannah, I finally feel like I am the real me. I know it sounds soppy and everything, but honestly, she completes me. So let's raise our glass to the only woman in the world stupid enough to put up my laziness the rest of her life. Now, a couple of final thank you. This one goes to my best friend. What can I honestly say about these two losers, genuinely? One of them has no job. One of them's still in uni. Okay. They have literally failed at every single wedding task I've given her last year. I'm not being uncutting, Callum probably still hasn't written a speech. But you know what? I wouldn't change it for the world. And it's also really good to see Schofield brought his date tonight. He's got his right hand right there next to him. But honestly, I'm so lucky to have not just one best friend, but two best friends to share this day with. And I can rely on them both. Not to do what I told them to do, but at least rely on them in some kind of way. Well, honestly, I am blessed. You might be functionally useless or just all the time, but then again, so am I. So, you know, what can we say? If there's one thing that I could change about my life, to be that closer to you guys. So Hannah's found a house in Dallas Shields for 170 grand. It's gonna buy it, move on up. And honestly, I wouldn't want to share a special day with anyone else standing by my side. So, to Calvin's go.
Better be music.
Very drunk, sorry.
Yesterday.
Right. So, what can we what can we say about Matthew? I'm Callum. Hello. Hello. I'm co-best man. Yes, co-best man. In 2018 we have two best men. I'm sure everyone will be best man eventually, you know. That's the modern world we live in. Everyone gets a participation trophy. Instead, you know, I've known him for 16 years. And he turns around to me and says, oh, you're best man. But you're not the best man. You are co-best man. So, you know, I have to share the stage with someone else. My best friend, who I've known 16 years. And I have to stand up here with some guy. Who didn't even write a speech. He's got nothing written down. Claims it's in his head. It's not. Bear with me. Okay. Oh, this is quite good. You might like this bit. No, wait a minute. Okay. Look at me, I'm shaking like a Scotsman in a salad bar. Yeah. That was good, I just thought of that. That's a good one. No. Okay. We've known each other for 16 years. I don't actually remember how we met. I remember him sat at the back of the class, and I thought, Jesus Christ, he's annoying. And then I got to know him, and I thought, Jesus Christ, he's really annoying. We occupied a weird space in school. We were, you know, we weren't unpopular to be bullied. We were also so unpopular that the girls never actually came near us. They were just like we were Jimmy Savile, you know. See, I actually thought, should I put that in? It might be inappropriate. But then I thought, it's a room for Scottish people, so, you know. I mean, basically, they're scum. That's why this is so terrible. Really drunk. So, I just want to say that Matthew, I love you. No, that's not me being drunk talking. That's legit, I do really love him. He's so nice. So is Hannah. He's such a nice couple. And the wedding was really nice. And I actually got invited. You know, mess. So, and his parents are really nice, they treat me really nice throughout the years. I know you're not my actual brother, but I kind of feel like you are in a weird way. I remember at the engagement party, your mom came up to me and said, oh, you've been like a brother? She was pissed. But what she said was true. The sentiment was, you know, true. I do think of you as a brother, and I am paying for you to go to New York with me, so yeah. Good. I don't really know what to say. Right, so I'm going to shut up now because I'm rambling, I'm drunk.
Yeah.
I'm going to pass you over to the other best man, who apparently has memorized the speech. Hello.
Okay, so I
have right, so thank you, Callum. Yes. Right, yes, I am the other best man, I'm Matt, or just to avoid any confusion, just call me Stone.
Yeah!
I have and it's all up here. I practiced the shower this morning. Anyway. And did you stand there, believe it or not? So you can know whether still to be physically mentally being friends with him. So yeah. He's picked us today to talk a bit about what it's like being friends with him, giving insights into what it's like. So it's hard because 17 years, how do you sum that up? Really, all the events we've been on, all the times we've had, everything, it is hard. So I could talk for hours, I'm not going to, but I could. Yes, with every speech, you need to start from the beginning. So my beginning begins, I said, 17 years ago, we were 10. Tim and his family moved, like, just to the street next to mine, like a stone's throw away. So we moved schools, we were in year 5 at the time. And it was about Easter. I remember our teacher saying to us, when you come back off your week, you get a week off for Easter, when you come back, there's going to be a new kid joining the class, and his name's Matt. So I remember thinking, great, another boy in the class, which is good. Just in our school, you're either a footballer or a nerd. So I don't really need to say which category we fell into, let's be honest. So I remember on his first day, he comes in on Monday, and he looked normal. He wasn't wearing trainers, so I thought, well, he might not be a footballer. We didn't have a Power Rangers lunchbox, so I thought he might not be a nerd, so it was hard to categorise him, really. And we go out in the morning, we go out for playtime, and he walks over to the footballers, and I thought, we're not going to have much to do with him, he likes football. Yeah. Anyway, about 5 minutes later, about 5 minutes later he comes over to us because the footballers have figured him out. It worked out, he didn't belong with them. And one of the first things he said to me was, I can burp the alphabet from A to Z. First things, maybe those initiation, maybe that's what he thought, that's what he had to do, but he did it then and then. Without any drinking, like didn't drink any water, didn't stop for breath, he just did it. And as a 10-year-old, I remember thinking, this is one of the best things I've ever seen. I remember this, yeah, I thought as far as I was concerned, he was one of us. Yeah. So actually, Mannah, it was around this time that he had his heart broken. It's quite sad. And none of you will know this, but he used to be a librarian in school. Primary was a while ago. And if you returned your book late or you didn't have your library card, you knew about it. He was very protective of his books. He was like one of these creepy old librarians that shushes you every time you make a noise in the library. I do apologise to any librarians here, but yeah. But there was somebody else in the library who used to work there, her name was Rose. Anyway, he was good friends with this Rose, they got on very well. I remember in the morning, he comes up to me and he said, me and this Rose are going out. About, it was the end of the day, so the day passed, about 6 hours later, and this Rose girl comes up to me and she says, oh, you're friends with Matt, aren't you? And I said, yeah. And she goes, oh, good, tell him he's dumped. 5 hours, all it took. We'll say though, he's had a bit, you know, before Hannah, he did well, you know, with dating and other women. We went on a date once with an artist. So we went to an art gallery. Walk around the art gallery taking all like pieces, and he goes up to this one particular artwork and he says, oh, I don't like that, it's not very good. It turned out to be the artwork of the person he was on a date with. So I don't think they ever saw each other again after that. No. But he's good. I mean, you know, he's attempted to help me with women as well. It's not always worked, in fact it never did work. So remember once we were out, I was trying to talk to somebody, I wasn't really getting anywhere. And then we were in this club in Liverpool called the Crazy House.
Yeah!
It's, yeah. I remember I was talking to the girl, not really getting anywhere with her. So he saw that I was struggling. And stage, no, not as tall as this, it's about near enough the same height. He gets up on stage, goes to the edge, got about 5 or 6 drinks in his hand, and he jumps off the stage head first, like face plants to the floor. Bees go everywhere. I said, why did you do that? He said, because it'll be funny and it will make you laugh and it'll give you something to talk about. So, you know, so he's considerate in a way. I think I'm going to have to stop embarrassing you now. Just, you stand, just stand for me just a minute. I'm going to have to be nice now and stop embarrassing you, I think, but I've never, you know I don't really do emotion ever, so bear with me on this. If I start welling up, I do apologise, but like, I've never said this before, but like, when you first came up here, it was quite, I think bittersweet's a good word, really, because look, 2 years ago, because on the one hand, like, I was so happy for you because you met Hannah, you were so happy, you were, you know, happiest I'd seen you in a while, you were so, you know, you were ecstatic, coming up here, new life, you met, you were so lovely, but I think on the other hand, I knew I wouldn't see you as much, so selfishly, it was a bit, like, I felt sort of 2 ways about it, but I think I can speak for, you know, for me and Callum, you know, as he said. No, he's not going to speak again. No, dude, seriously. As he said before, when he said he thinks of you as a brother, it's the same with me. And, you know, the 3 of us, and that's what it's been. And I do miss you at home. We all miss you at home even now. And I think it's not so much like the big event, like the big night, so much. It's more because we live so close to each other. It's more like, say, if I was sitting at home, wasn't doing anything, I used to think, oh, I'll go around to Hustles, play some games. I think it's that kind of thing that I miss, but I'm used to it now because it's been 2 years, of course. But I do still, even now, think, I wonder what you're doing, or what are you? But I think to speak really for, you know, for me and Calum, your family, your friends, how proud we are of you. You know, coming up here, you know, moving away, and it's a big move, but how well you've done. I haven't said this actually, your ride looks amazing. Finally. Yeah, and she's lovely as well, and, you know, your new family are as well. You've got this lovely new family, and it's just really, really good to see, and we're all proud of you. So, can I just ask you all to stand again, please? I haven't got a drink, so I can't join in, but can we have a toast to Matt and Hannah, please? Matt and Hannah? And that's it.
policies a thing, but a country song by Kenny Rogers is getting more people on the dance floor than any other song.
Every camper knows the secret to surviving.
What?